and I can show you on the flight simulator chart. This is the area that we're flying to. Changi is over here. Now I'm going to set my diversion as Kuala Lumpur over here, which, if the conditions are very, very bad here, I'd like to think that, you know, perhaps 40, 50 nautical miles away, maybe more, that the weather would be more favourable. So the code for this is Whiskey Mike Kilo Kilo. So in the VNAV we're going to go to, on the FMC, so we're going to go to route and show you page 1. We're going to go route 2. Origin is not so important, the destination is important, which is WMKK. Now we're not going to activate this, so it's not going to modify our current routing. And if we want to, we can put in our origin, not so important, but I will put it in anyway. And on the departure and arrival page, route 2, WMKK. So assuming that we're going to have a northeasterly or a northern or an eastern coming headwind, a facing runway, the nearest to that for this airport would be ILS. Unfortunately, they're not exactly in the same direction. So I guess the nearest would have to be runway 14. So we'll take runway 14 left. And we'll just leave that there in the route to. So we've got direct to this runway. Now if we ever need that, we're going to press activate, and that will simply re-input the new flight as the active flight route. It's very, very simple. It's almost not worth talking about, to be honest. It's so simple. But it's there now, and that's what we need. That's marvellous. Now, we're just about to fly over this waypoint. So as we do that, it's always a good idea in the cruise to put the arrival information in as soon as you can on route. So at the moment 30 degrees of flap is going to give us 156 knots. Now that gives us a reference speed on the speed tape over here in advance, and also the information of the runway we have over here is quite useful. So we have a 4,000 meter runway, 13,000 feet, which seems very, 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 very long. Three to go till we start the nice left turn. And round we go. Let's realign the heading indicator. It's giving us 269 or so. Then we look at the progress page. Step climb, it says, in 900 nautical miles. That will be up to 39,000. I'll go up to do that when I want, of course, but it would be nice to follow the computer, because we'll arrive with the planned fuel, with the estimated fuel, if we follow the computer closely. And considering it's very bad weather, we don't want to be playing around with going up too soon or wasting fuel and then ending up with, you know, 23 or 24,000, but then landing with below minimums. If we have to go around twice perhaps, and then I decide to divert and then I have to go around there, we'll just run out of fuel. So we'll stick to the flight management computer's recommendations. Okay, so it's looking good. I know I haven't spoken about it in too much detail in this video about the equi time point, but the more I think about it as I'm flying, the more almost a waste of time it is, really, because I don't have the maps available, and I just can't find them online. And so if I just talk about it, what's in my mind, it's almost impossible to tell you what's in my mind exactly in the same detail, so you can follow me, really. The equi time point I do talk about in the first half of this video, when I flew from Buenos Aires to Nadi to Fiji. So at least watch that if you're interested. That flight was over water for sort of 80% of the flight, so a turn back point is more required, is more beneficial and advised, of course. Whereas on this flight we're flying through lots of islands, can't see any now, but they are around. So over here, for example, now you can see they're just scattered around. So if we would know before takeoff on our list of the possible alternates along the route, and each airport along the route we would have also its documentation, and I can't possibly find every alternate on route that can land a 747 and find the charts for that as well. I mean, I'd never get the video done, but at least if I talk about it, you can consider it in your own flying and have an awareness of it happening in the real world as well. So for example, this airfield that we're coming up to, if I turn off the station, it's Whiskey Alpha Papa Papa. So we have a little look through the paperwork, see if that's one of them. Oh yes, it is, okay. Maybe that has a runway that's 9,000 feet or 6,000 feet. We would have a weather report, or we could get one. And then we would know if we have to divert that we could just do that right turn and land there safely. In which case we might have a ring, a fix around it, so we know where we are in terms of distance quickly to it. But unfortunately I can't really do that with every single airport. However, what I will do, if I put this on plan view, you can see that we are on route to Mike Kilo Sierra. So we're currently on this leg, and then we're sort of going into the actual approach, so we're sort of almost there really. So if we did have some kind of emergency that didn't warrant an emergency landing or land as soon as possible situation, we would probably continue. We may even I think if we had an emergency, come to think of it, but we had an emergency of the kind where we could continue flying to destination, we could probably land at Kuala Lumpur and assume that has the better weather, of course, rather than try landing in bad weather at Changi. That would be stupid. Just lots and lots of variables, really. But what I will do anyway is, if I just step forward so we can see it a bit better here, I will put a fix of Kuala Lumpur, which is, if I go to Route 2, what's the WMKK? Here's WMKK. We can see where the airport is. I'll have to step forward a bit. Sorting around here. Zoom out. We can see that it's over here, basically. So I could put a fix around there, and we could say 60. I'm zoomed out, of course, to 640 nautical miles, so it looks close, but it isn't. Now let's try 110. It's more like it. So that 110 ring is quite near our actual approach path, so the airport. So if we keep that fixed there at 110, we know that probably about 115 or so nautical miles remains for us to fly if we are to divert to Kuala Lumpur or not land at Changi and continue. That would be another 120 nautical miles. So that's something that we could just perhaps leave on the screen, and when we get closer we'll see that ring just off the side of the page, because the airfield is just off to the northwest, so it would be sort of on a heading of about 290 or maybe 310, something like that. So that will help us with our decision making. It already has, actually. It tells me it's about 120 nautical miles away. That's quite useful to know, rather than do it when we're carrying out a missed approach, flying around and deciding where we should go. We already know. So we're staying ahead of the aircraft. Progress page, 850 for the step climb, 1780 to go. Just passing 247 nautical miles to go to all Mike Kilo Sierra. After that, we'll step climb up to flight level 390. 245 to go. Coming up on 4 nautical miles now for Mike Kilo Sierra. After the right turn, as I say, we're going to step climb. This is 127 nautical miles up to 370, but I would like to go to flight level 3. 90. 38. We'll go to flight level 380. Down we go. Line up the heading bug. There's the mark for our step climb. So let's pop in 380. Have a look at the new figures. The aircraft won't climb, of course, because the altitude window has not been changed. Actually, I want to go vertical speed on this one, so we'll start off with 400 feet per minute. Cruise speed is being recommended as 0.849 or so. 0.85 is okay. We can stay like this. I'm gonna get 5 out of that. $900 to go. $250, $200. Just check the revised speed, 0.854 now, but VNav can take over that anyway, but I'll just set it here. To go, altitude capture. Speed gets carried away sometimes, I'm just encouraging the engines to calm down a little bit. It's pretty much stabilized. VNav, half. So 260 to go until Rocket does Mike. About 380. 5.5. Not 287 on the heading. Having a look at the progress page, you can see we're just passing that big 1,000 nautical mile mark. You wait to see that for many, many hours. That was 4,500 when we started. So we've come a long way. Still got the same fuel as we expected, about 33,000. Anything above 30 is good. And when we get a bit closer to the airport, I'll tune into the ATIS and we'll just keep that tuned in until the aircraft picks up that frequency as soon as possible. So the moment it does, we'll suddenly start hearing it. And that will help us to plan. Maybe we'll have to modify the arrival. Hopefully we'll take runway 02 left. $1,000 to destination, $234 to Bobby Dutton. 10 nautical miles to go till Bobby Dutton Mike. Next is the Papa November Kilo, 388 to go. Just about to fly over the waypoint now. There we go, 380 to go. Now, what I want to do is pick up that ATIS frequency for Changi, and from the chart we can see it's 128.6. So I'm going to pop in 128.6. And we'll just leave that open. And and wait for it to pick up that information, which of course won't be now. 760 nautical miles away. We might be lucky with about 70 to 100 perhaps. We'll see what happens. .370 to go. Just having a look at the chart here. We're on our way now to PNK. And after that we're going to make that left turn towards, it was Repov here. We're flying out to Repov. It's the beginning of our approach. So hopefully once we've passed Pontianak, we'll begin to pick up the ATIS around this point here once we're in that oceanic control area. Just a quick update on the map there for you. 150 to go. Just past 4 for the PNK VOR, just about to turn left. That will be, at last, on our way to our initial approach fix. That's the first waypoint of the actual star. Standard arrival. Now it's along this leg that I'm hoping to pick up the ATIS. We'll just revise the ref speed. It's now 147 because we're lighter, of course. Three ATIS to go. Start to see the coastline soon. Having a look at the fuel, 31.6 now. Anything above 30 would be comfortable. Just coming up on 250 nautical miles now from Repov, our initial approach fix. You'll notice if we look outside that the weather's slightly worsened. The visibility is just reduced a little bit for us, and the clouds are building a spot. That's because, of course, we're coming into that very, very bad area of weather. So we'll keep an eye on that, and hopefully pick up that ATIS very, very soon. Our frequency is still tuned in correctly, 128.6. And in real life, we would be listening to other aircraft en route who are perhaps ahead of us a little bit, and see what's going on, if we can pick up any activity from the airport, and receiving regular weather updates anyway. 245 to go, everything's looking good on the FMC. Still over 30 for the fuel, and not forgetting that we also have Route 2 programmed, should we have to divert up to Kuala Lumpur. Otherwise, top of descent just over 160 to go. We'll pick up again towards the top of descent. Here we are, 64 nautical miles from Repov, and you might notice the weather is not too good. We now have a bit of a strong wind coming out of 167 degrees, and the visibility is not very good. Small bounce on the VNAV, but not to worry. Approaching our top of descent now, so everyone's going to be sitting down. And I think we're ready for descent, so we'll go ahead and request a descent. 7 nautical miles to go. Now I'm going to reset my altitude now to flight level 270 in preparation for the VNAV descent. This will change automatically on passing. 4 to go. Excellent, there's the ATIS. We'll be landing on 02. VNAV descent, power idle. We'll leave the ATIS going so we can pick it up on occasion. Two aircraft ahead of us now, over 10,000 feet. well, one of them's actually 8,500 blast, one of them's more than 10. Okay. So there's severe thunderstorms in the area. I think she said quarter mile visibility. Not looking forward to that. This is going to be a full ILS. 40 nautical miles to go to Repov. VNAV holding us nicely. If we look at what the VNAV is giving us, 0.852 until 300 knots. We just achieved 300 knots as I was talking. I think so. The nose is just going to pitch up and just do its best to hold 300 knots with power idle, which will result in a vertical speed of around, well, you see we're getting about 3,000 or so, but that sort of should be more like 2,400, considering the speed's getting a bit carried away, but that's because of the wind. Keeping an eye on this aircraft out to the left, that seems to be going away from us as we cross altitudes, so that aircraft is not a problem. This aircraft is currently 10,000 below us, which means it's more than 21,000 feet. It's, you know, or below, and on the actual approach we can't see anything just yet. However, what we're going to do is review the go-around procedure as the aircraft is descending, and we'll continue that descent to flight level 210. Which will put us just before Repov at the beginning of the initial approach fix. Descent profile is centralised, looking good. Over to the chart. So the missed approach procedure is going to be out to Acoma on a north-south hold to the right. It will be straight out and a bit of a left turn onto 335. So I'll set 335 on the heading indicator during the actual approach once we're no longer using it. What was that heading again? 335. I'm going to tune into the Tekong VOR, VTK. And I think this one over here for the actual end of the ILS, beginning of the ILS, but I'll put this frequency in also, which is Sierra Juliet. So that's VTK, Sierra Juliet. I'll pop those in just now. So we'll go to the nav page. And we have Sierra Juliet in the right VOR. We don't need any course. And the other one was VTK. Victor Tango Kilo. I'll pop on the Victor Tango Kilo and I'll pop on the Sierra Juliet. Both would be identified in real life, but you can see that they have been picked up correctly. And if I centralise the map, you can see they're centralising and lining up well. So we have a bit of orientation for when we're flying, because I'm going to have an image of the arrival chart in my mind. So the runway heading is 023, but will be offset because the wind is coming from 08 something or other, so from our right. So we're going to have a crosswind from the right, so our actual approach heading will probably be something like 030, something like that. We're intercepting at 3,500 Anuma. Missed approach is climb to 1,000, we must remember this, climb to 1,000 feet. And then a climbing left turn to 4,000 feet. So in other words, climb to 1,000, then start turning left to 335 up to 4,000. And we've got the 356 radial from Papa Uniform, that says, but that will be into the FMC. So Papa Uniform's over here. I'm just going to check in the FMC. It's going out, here's our route, going out to Acoma. runway track to 1000, left 335, intercept 356. So it's actually all there now. Now there seems to be a bit of a problem with this VNAV, so I'm going to intercept with vertical speed and reduce that rate of descent. We'll continue the descent at 1600 feet per minute. Just a bit of a problem there, probably because of that tailwind. So descent rate is reduced to 1600, bringing our speed back. Now we don't have speed protection because I'm in vertical speed mode, so I need to keep a very close eye on that indicated airspeed. Tend to go to Repov, just want to look at that map once more. So I don't need to tune in this VOR, but come to think of it, because I didn't know when I said I'm going to tune into this VTK, I didn't know that we're going to actually be using the proper uniform VOR. So what I am going to do instead is change this VTK VOR in VOR left and put in PU and put the radial of 356, which is already in the FMC, in the legs page, but I'm going to tune it so we again have an awareness of our situation. So I'm going to first of all continue the descent to flight level 150. And we're going to put in proper uniform into VOR left now. That's identified, and the radial was 356. Around we go, Repov. That's now going to show on the navigation display. I just want to have a look at the legs places and the altitude restrictions. So at or below 250 for Repov, where we were, that's good. Next one is 6,000 at or above REMS. So let's not go below 6,000 at REMS. Still got 146 on the approach. That's looking good. No aircraft in our vicinity, just like the heading indicator. Just past that Repov now. We're heading about 347 or so. Could bring back the speed now to about 280 knots. That descent rate is going to come back to 1400. Now I'm in control, not in VNAV. Vertical descent profile showing that we're about 2,500 above what we should be. But if we need to descend any more quickly, we will use the speed brakes to do that. There's that radial that we would be picking up from that VOR, but on the other side. Speed is coming back nicely. Once we hit 280, I'll press flight level change. That will increase our rate of descent and give us a maximum descent. To REMS and 4,000 to go to flight level 150. Speed 280 knots, flight level change. Flight change speed, thrust. Increased rate of descent, that's what we wanted. Nine to REMS. One aircraft ahead of us at 8,000 or more, as in 8,000 or lower.